Thousands of cases of Lyme disease are reported every year in the U.S. And most recently, Justin Timberlake announced he has the disease. Fans reported sluggish performances during his recent tour. Videos went viral showing Timberlake actually putting the mic down and having most of his fans sing his lyrics. In an Instagram post, he talked about the fatigue he had been feeling while on the road. Joining us live now is Dr. Michael Calderwood from Dartmouth Health. Thank you for being with us.
Happy to be here.
So I want to dive right into the questions. Fatigue is a common symptom of Lyme disease, but it's also a common symptom of so many other things. So what other symptoms should people be looking out for?
So Lyme disease is one of the kind of few tick-borne related illnesses that we see around this time of year. And I think it's important to mention that it's not just Lyme disease. There are some other things that one can get from ticks and even others from mosquitoes. So it's important to think about all of these. But focused on Lyme disease, the most common thing we see early on is a characteristic rash, and it occurs near the site of the tick bite. It's called the bullseye rash, or the medical term is erythema migrans. And originally, it may just be a large red blotch. But over time, it kind of has a center area of redness and then a larger ring of redness around it. It really does resemble a bullseye. Now, that often will go away on its own, but really should be treated, both because treatment can quicken how quickly that goes away, and it can prevent some of the later complications of Lyme disease. And those include things such as infection of a joint, often a knee, that can swell up and require treatment. But also you can have things like a facial nerve palsy, where a side of your face may begin to sag, or effects on the heart itself, where the electrical conduction on the heart may be impacted. So there are a number of manifestations of Lyme disease after that early rash.
Sure. And I want to ask you quickly, how do you treat that rash? You talk about early treatment as soon as you treat that rash. What would happen if someone goes to the doctor with that bullseye rash?
So doxycycline is an antibiotic that is given twice a day. It actually is very effective for the treatment of Lyme disease. It also is very effective for treatment of another tick-borne illness, anaplasma, that we see quite frequently around this time. Depending on if you're early or later in terms of when we've diagnosed the Lyme disease, we would give a week, 7 to 10 days of treatment, all the way out to 3 to 4 weeks. And so it really depends on where you are how long you've had the illness.
Sure. And sometimes diagnoses can be missed. I mean, it can go years before somebody knows that they have Lyme disease. How are diagnoses sometimes missed?
Well, again, often the rash is attributed to something else, and it may be that early on the rash is attributed to a medication, and people think it's a medication-related allergy. It may be related to something like poison ivy and misdiagnosed as some other contact dermatitis. So that's one thing, is that the rash is not always attributed to Lyme disease. Now, the swelling of the knee is very characteristic for what we see with other bacteria, such as Staph aureus infections that cause skin infections and what we call septic arthritis, or bacterial infection of a joint. And things that cause delays in the heart, there are many things that can cause that. Similarly, there are many things that can cause the face to droop. And so you really have to have a broad list of things that Lyme disease can cause, and always be thinking, this is a season where we're seeing a lot of ticks. Ask the person about their outdoor exposures, but not everyone is gonna actually recall having been bitten by a tick. And we can talk a little bit about how you might look for that, how you might prevent that. But again, it is having a high index of suspicion, really from that first thaw after the winter, all the way through into the fall. We see a lot of ticks, and people really see these on their pets when they're out walking. They may see them on their own skin. They may see them on their family members, and it's important.
All right, Dr. Michael Calderwood, thank you so much for being with us, and such great advice there. Try to catch it early. Thank you.
Thank you very much.